नमस्ते, वेलकम टू बीटीयू ई शिक्षण प्रोग्राम। आई डॉक्टर दाक्षायणी आर पाटिल, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर एट बीएमएस कॉलेज ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर बैंगलोर, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू वंस अगेन। वी आर करेंटली डूइंग द कोर्स बिल्डिंग सर्विसेज 3, मॉड्यूल्स 1 एंड 2 डीलिंग विद मैकेनिकल वेंटिलेशन एंड एयर कंडीशन सिस्टम्स। द कोर्स टाइटल 18 ARC 63 फॉर बीआरसी 6th सेमेस्टर अंडर बीटीयू for the current even semester, April to August 2021. So this is an initiative by Vishveshwaraya Technological University, Belagavi, under the e-learning center initiatives. So the course, modules 1 and 2 lecture sessions, we are doing the module 2, overview of the syllabus. So air conditioning systems, understanding the various types available and the various design aspects of the same. The list of references. So let us begin the lecture 5 session under module 2, air conditioning systems and the types, package AC and rooftop AC. To recollect, in the past 4 lectures of module 2, we have got an introduction to the air conditioning system, the various types, classifications, advantages, scope of AC in buildings, historical review, and then we have seen in detail the working of unitary AC systems. We began with window AC or unit AC or room AC, so called as. So continuing the discourse on unitary systems, which cater to singular spaces or single spaces, single rooms, single zones in a building, we are going to do another 2 types. We have completed window AC and split AC as well in the last lecture. So today we will do the package AC unit and rooftop AC unit. So these are the 2 types we will look at. To begin with, package AC system, as the nomenclature suggests, it is packaged into a single component. Window AC was also a single cabinet with all the components assembled, factory assembled, and placed on the windowsill. Package ACs are extensions of the same, and they come as a single console model which can be placed on the floor of different varieties. The left one is vertically taller, whereas the right one has a shorter height. So as the space, the building space, the room demands, likewise we have to select an appropriate model. So how do we define a package AC? Packaged or package air conditioner is a self-contained unit suitable for floor mounting, designed to provide conditioned air to moderate sized conditioned spaces. So as per NBC, National Building Code, Volume 2, which deals with mechanical ventilation and air conditioning systems. So package AC is a self-contained unit, self-contained in the sense it has all the components of a refrigeration cycle that is required to run an air conditioner. And it is packaged such that it can be kept on the floor, and it is designed with the objective of catering to moderate sized spaces. So room AC was for small rooms or spaces. Package AC will cater a little more beyond that to moderate sized conditioned spaces. So package AC has a wide range of applications, in the sense it can cater to various building uses such as office, club, restaurant, showrooms, commercial retail showrooms, departmental stores, banquet halls, and such other amenities. So it will cater to a wide range of spatial applications wonderfully well, mid-sized. So essentially now the package AC system will include a refrigeration of system for cooling and dehumidification of the used room air, right? So this is a basis for any air conditioning system to run. So refrigeration cycle forms the foundation or basis for such a AC system, and this is integrated component wise into the package AC. It should include a facility for drawing of fresh air and mixing it with the return air. So this takes care of the ventilation part of the air conditioning. So it should have a component, an opening or a damper to control the inlet of fresh air, the outside fresh air into the system via using a motor, a fan, and an inlet to control the same. It mixes with the return air. Return air refers to the used vitiated air which has to be cooled and cleaned and dehumidified. It should have a means for cleaning of the mixed return air and the fresh air. So that means it should have a filtration system embedded in it to clean the air, that is the air from the room and the fresh outside air that is mixed up. It should have a provision for external air distribution ducting. So little amount of quantum of ducting is coming into picture now. For window AC, there was no ducting. For split AC, there was a little bit again, a minimum ducting and piping required to connect the indoor to the outdoor. In this case, distribution ducting for uniform air distribution in the conditioned space. So again, a similar quantum of ducting might come into picture when we are using capacities beyond 5 or 10. Now this is a sketch or view of the package AC unit. Again, this unit comes with two compartments, the upper compartment and the lower compartment, because we have to segregate the cooling side and the hot side, similar to what we did in the window AC and the split AC. So upper compartment will comprise of, let us begin from the top. We have, or rather the most important part, the evaporator coil, which is also called as the cooling coil. Evaporator coil synonymous with cooling coil. And it will come with a fan motor, evaporator fan, fan belt, right? So now in this particular section, we are looking at the room side on the left hand side. That is why the front panel, which is called as a fan compartment, front panel and return air grill. So you see my cursor, that is the front panel with the return air grill. So what does it mean? The return air grill refers to the grill which is getting in the used room air into the system. So used air, vitiated air, is entering the package unit through the return air grill in the front. Okay, then to the parallel side, just next to the return air grill would be the supply air grill. Supply air grill will give the cooled, cleaned, dehumidified air back into the room. So behind the return air grill, we have the TEEV, that is the throttling device or the thermal evaporative wall that controls the refrigerant flow into the evaporator. So then we have the evaporator coil, right behind it. There are lots of pipes, which are the refrigerant distributing copper pipes. There is suction line, right? So the fan above is going to create the suction such that the used air enters through the return air grill into the system and flows over the evaporator coil. And the bottom compartment, called as a lower compartment, has the compressor. These are the working components. And the water-cooled condenser in this case. Condenser is the one in which the refrigerant is going to condense back to the liquid state, right? So it gets hot and has to be cooled. So we use two options, either air or water, to cool the condenser. In this case, since it's a water-cooled condenser, we need to have a water tank or a water supply tank to keep the cooling process on. Hence, you see the liquid line happening there, and it is connected to a water source. Now, below you have a front panel for the machine compartment for accessing, for maintenance, for repairs, etc. Electrical panel to control the electrical distribution to the system. So this is the various components arranged in the upper compartment and the lower compartment of the package AC unit. Now the process is going to be similar to the vapor compression refrigeration cycle, right? So the air from the room, which has to be cooled, enters through the front panel return air grill, which also has the air filter. So as it enters the system through the return air grill across the filter, it is going to get cleaned to whatever degree or efficiency the filter is designed for. So it arrests the impurities that are laden or dispersed in the air. Okay, and then further on, it passes through the evaporator coil, which has two coils parallelly running, one in which the refrigerant is flowing. Refrigerant is the fluid which takes the heat from air and transfers it to the refrigerant. Heat from the air transferred to the refrigerant, where it boils and becomes a vapor state. So parallelly there is a fluid. Now, once it passes through that via the throttling device or the evaporative control, refrigerant control valve, from the evaporator, further it goes to the compressor, where the liquid is undergoing a change of the refrigerant is undergoing change of state from liquid to vapor and has to be brought back to its liquid form, so it gets cooled in the condenser. So this is the process, the normal refrigeration cycle that happens here also, and the components are assembled in a casing console model, either vertical or it is a horizontal model, and it continues. The condenser is cooled by water, hence we need a water tank supply required in this case. If it were a air-cooled condenser, then we have to rely on the atmospheric outside air to cool the condenser. For that, you need to make a different set of arrangement. Now, if it's a water-cooled condenser, you can place the package AC anywhere within the given space. If it were an atmospheric air-cooled, then we need to have access to the outdoor air entering into the system. So, you will have to draw the sketch along with explaining the components, sequence of the refrigeration cycle that happens here to induce the air conditioning. You can always go back and refer to the refrigeration lecture. So we will consider package AC as extensions of window AC, bigger versions of window AC, and they are available in capacities of 3, 5, 7, 10, up to 15 ton as per different manufacturers. There are different sets of guidelines, but otherwise, between 3 to 15 tonnage, we get capacities of a package AC, which is enhanced version when compared to window AC or split AC. So the condenser is either air cooled or water cooled. In case of water cooled condenser, which is completely factory assembled, tested and charged with the refrigerant before being installed, So water type condenser is totally factory manufactured. The pipes are tested for the right pressure and charged with the refrigerant before being installed on the site. Thus, what happens? It reduces the amount of field work involved and is recommended when field work is not possible or not available or needs to be eliminated from the installation process. So water cooled type has this kind of an advantage. Air cooled type, on the other hand, requires substantial field work for installing, because you need access to the outdoor atmospheric air. The pipes have to be laid, the dampers have to be in place, right, and the motors also. But it is preferable where water is definitely a short commodity. Air is available everywhere, so when water is not easily available, readily available, we rely on air-cooled type of condenser. Air-cooled type is usually for capacities below 5 ton, whereas water-cooled, you can avail capacities beyond 5 up to 15 ton. Water-cooled condensers in the package unit give higher capacity at lower power consumption. So that means the efficient output with respect to the ton of cooling, refrigeration ton, is higher at lesser power consumption when compared with the air-cooled type. So these are the advantages that are with the water-cooled condenser. Package units are generally available with a vertical air discharge, like the section that we just saw, that was the side panel discharge, but they are available with on top, that is a vertical air discharge also. At that time, the unit is shorter in height. However, horizontal air discharge unit may also be procured, but heat island effect should be avoided. In the sense, stagnation of the heat on in the room in specific corners. Now, limitations of AC system, where we cannot suitably or comfortably use them: large multi-storied buildings where increasing the number of compressors may entail subsequent maintenance problems or require a good substantial amount of regular intervals and access to the units, etc. So we do not want that to happen. Hence, limited or not so comfortably applied in large multi-storied buildings. In such cases, it is advisable to go in for central air conditioning. We are going to study that in the next module, in the next lecture. Limitation number two, where length of air distribution ducting exceeds 30 meter. So duct is the component, linear component, which carries the air from one point to another in the AC system. Ducts are of various sizes as per the quantum of air they have to transport. So duct will transport the hot air to the appliance, cooled air to the room. So in instances where we cannot achieve ducting below the 30 meter range. It happens, the building spatial plan, layout, or there are constraints. It ends up such a way that the duct is extending beyond 30 meter. So from the unit to the place where it has to cool, then it is ideally not advisable to use package AC. In instances where the vertical distance of air-cooled condenser from the packaged unit exceeds about 20 meter. So packaged unit, say the supply air grill part, the evaporative, the evaporator coil part, and if the air-cooled condenser where the vertical distance exceeds about 20 meters. The sum of horizontal and vertical distance should generally be kept within 25 meters. Where high filtration efficiency is expected, such as hospital ICUs, it is not recommended because the filtration media is not so efficient to achieve 99% or 100% efficiency or cleaning of the room. You can refer National Building Code for more elaborate details on the same. In applications such as operation theatres, where high percentage of fresh air is needed to clear the exhausted air, and also where fire hazards exist, depending on the type of anesthesia being used, it has limited applications. So fans provided at the evaporator side, that is the cooling side, room side, develop higher static pressure, and this aids in better air throw. What is air throw? So this is just an indicative image from any unit of an AC, which is on the supply side, that is supplying the cooled, cleaned, dehumidified air into the room. The throw is the distance until which it can reach. So normally this throw should be designed on the longer side of the room. So package AC fans normally aid in better throw, which is the expected objective in an air conditioning system. Air distribution is done through minor ducting when required. Air quantities are usually in the range of 10 to 11.3 cubic meters per minute per ton. So that is the average output, efficiency output per tonnage. And moving ahead. In critical application such as computer room, computer labs, which need higher rate of airflow, higher capacity fans with airflow up to 550 cubic feet per minute are provided. So that is also possible, right? So you can use a package AC system in critical applications such as computer labs, which need better rate of airflow because the equipment are emanating more heat into the space. So what there are three aspects that cater to heat gain in the indoor space. One is the people, users who are perspiring, who are breathing out, the lighting of various degrees or qualities, and the various equipment or appliances in the room. So when you have a computer room, it emanates more heat into the room and requires better ventilation, that requires better air flow rates. This usually needs to be factored in during the design of the system. So when we are doing the heat load calculation, we need to be careful to include these kind of additional heat gains or sources in a given space. For larger loads, multiple units may be installed with one common cooling tower for the water-cooled condenser. Okay, so for larger loads, you can use multiple indoor units with common cooling tower. So that becomes an efficient way of using a unit power or energy usage of the single cooling tower. In such cases, just to recap, the upper compartment has the evaporator coil, also called as a cooling coil. It has a fan to suck in the used air, motor to run the fan, air grills for the air to enter into the system, filters to clean the air, expansion valve to control the refrigerant flowing in a cyclic manner into the evaporator, right? Because at the condenser, the refrigerant became a liquid from a vapor state. So suddenly it has to be collected. So there is a receiver tank for the refrigerant. From the receiver tank, the refrigerant is going to be flowing into the evaporator, the quantity of which is controlled by the expansion valve. And also while doing so, the pressure drops. Control panel, that is the user interface, which has calibration for the temperature control, which displays that, which might even show the humidity levels. Thermostat sensors to sense the temperature in the room. If it exceeds what we have set the machine for, it will immediately send the message for the compressor to start, and the cooling process is initiated. The lower compartment has the compressor, condenser, the electrical panel. This is the working component of the package AC. Package units can be mounted within the air conditioned space with discharge air plenum or in a separate room from where the air duct, air distribution duct is taken to the conditioned space. So previously, a couple of slides back, we saw that there is a little amount of ducting involved, and what should be the distance between the output unit and the condenser, right? So why that was thought about? You can either keep the package AC unit in the room where it will work with all the components together, or what we can do is we can place it in a room apart, and once the cooling happens there, the duct takes the cooled air to the room to which it has to cater to. So that is also a possibility if we do not want to house the package AC unit in the given space due to various concerns of space or let the aircraft fly by. So the ducts will take the cooled air to the space where it is cooled. In case the space doesn't essentially want to house the package unit due to space or aesthetics or function, right? So we need to resort to this type of ducting. While deciding the location, provision shall be kept for ease of servicing of the unit. Now, this is something which we normally do not think of in most of design decisions that we make. Say, designing a space, designing an equipment, post-occupancy and post-usage, maintenance or servicing also has to be thought of in most of the cases. So, similarly in package AC also, understanding how the maintenance personnel gets access and how is there enough space to take care of all that has to be decided when you decide on where to locate the unit. We can do a market survey on various package air conditioners available. We will get the specifications, the costing, the mode of operation, whether it's air cooled, the second one is air cooled, third one is water cooled with a heat pump, so it works as heating and cooling as also. So likewise the rates keep increasing. So some are deductible, some are non-deductible. Now the next component that we will look at would be rooftop AC unit, which we will see in the coming up lecture. All right. So until then, as an exercise to conclude the lecture on a package AC, advisable to do a quick market study, research on what are the types available, what are the specifications, capacities, spatial requirement by the manufacturer, because ultimately the manufacturer guidelines have to be followed in most cases. For installation and civil purposes, civil works, we follow the NBC codes, norms, and ASHRAE standards, right? So see you in the next session, that is lecture number 6.